Praise the Lord. I welcome you to Powerhouse Telecast. This is a beautiful day. I strongly believe with all my heart that the Lord is going to bless you. And before I bring today's message, I would like to take this opportunity to thank all of my listeners for standing behind me all this while till today. You know, the phone calls that I've been receiving from you are very uplifting. And the letters that you are writing are also good. So I want to encourage you all to keep on writing and keep on calling. This is a beautiful day that your life is never going to be the same, because the Lord has given me a fresh message from on high to bless you and your entire family. Wherever you are listening to this broadcast, please let us pray. My Lord and my God, I want to thank you so much for such a beautiful day and these wonderful people. Father, I ask that you will give me a fresh word to be of a blessing to all these folks today in the name of Jesus. And your word says it will never come to you void until it accomplishes whatever you have sent it for. So this day, O Lord, may your name be magnified in these homes in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. This Sunday, we are celebrating the triumphal entry of our Savior and our Lord Jesus Christ. That is called Palm Sunday. Hallelujah. And God has given me these few words to encourage you with it. See, one thing that I love about Jesus is that before his crucifixion, see, he demonstrated the power that he had. Jesus demonstrated his victory over death, his victory over sickness, his victory over Satan before he went on the cross. That makes him God. I believe that Jesus is God. Listen, before I became a Christian, you know, I criticized the so-called Pentecostals. I hated people who clapped their hands. I didn't like them at all. And when they speak in tongues, ah, man, that was another thing that I didn't like. But when I got saved, I made a research myself through the Bible. You know, I have read the Bible so many times, and I have come to realize that Jesus truly died. And I've also come to realize that he resurrected. Praise the Lord. And I've also known that Jesus is God. Before he died, he foresaw his death. And he knew that when he died, he was going to resurrect. So before he died, he came out to celebrate his victory over death openly. So this Palm Sunday has to be celebrated because it is true. Amen. And how do we know that it is true? We're going to see it from the scripture today. So we are taking our scriptures, we are taking our studies from the book of Mark. Mark chapter 1. I'm reading from verse 1 through 11. And when he came nigh to Jerusalem, unto Bethpage and Bethany, at the Mount of Olives, he sent forth two of his disciples, and said unto them, Go your way into the village over against you, and as soon as ye be entered into it, ye shall find a colt tied, whereon never man sat. Loose him and bring him. And if any man say unto you, Why do ye this? Say ye that the Lord has need of him, and straightway he will send him hither. And they went their way and found the colt tied by the door without in a place where two ways met, and they loosed him. And certain of them that stood there said unto them, What do ye, loosing the colt? And they said unto them, As Jesus had commanded, and they let them go. And they brought the colt to Jesus and cast their garments on him, and he sat upon him, and many spread their garments in the way, and others cut down branches off the trees and shrilled them in the way. And they that went before and they that had followed cried, saying, Hosanna, blessed is he that come in the name of the Lord. Blessed be the kingdom of our father David that come in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And Jesus entered into Jerusalem and into the temple. And when he had looked round about upon all things, and now the eventide was come, he went out into Bethany with the 12. Praise the Lord. It's about Jesus. When he was about to be crucified, he sent two of his disciples to a village close to him. And he told them that they should go into that village. And when they get into that village, they will see a colt tied on a tree. And they should loose the colt and bring the colt to him. He sent two people. And when they went, they saw the colt. And Jesus told them that some people are going to ask them what they were going to do with that animal. And he said, when they ask you the purpose of loosing this animal, let them know that the master needs it. And Jesus, as he commanded them, they went and they did the same thing. People asked them, what is the matter? Why are you taking this animal to? They told them, the master is in need of it. And the Bible says, when they brought the animal, they decorated the animal, and Jesus sat on the animal and went through the streets of Jerusalem. And when people saw Jesus coming, hallelujah, they spread their clothes on the floor and they were shouting, hallelujah, 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 Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Oh, praise the Lord. See, the prophets of old prophesied about this. And when Jesus came to the scene, he did the same for the prophecy to be fulfilled. Don't tell me that Jesus is not God. Jesus is God because he has insight. Jesus can tell you what will happen tomorrow. Oh, praise the Lord. He can tell you what is happening tomorrow. He told them, the disciples, all what were going to happen. And when they went, all what he told them took place. Who can do this except Jesus? Hallelujah. And he did what? He showed his victory. He showed his power. It's like Jesus going from the Bronx to Manhattan, walking downtown from maybe 45th Street down to the 14th Street, on the street of Manhattan, downtown, sitting on this animal, celebrating his victory over the devil. Jesus knew that he was going to die. And he knew that when he died, he would resurrect. He knew that the enemy would not have power over him. Praise the Lord. That is why Jesus went to Jerusalem to do what? To show his victory. So I've entitled this, The Triumphal Entry of Jesus in Jerusalem. He entered into Jerusalem triumphantly. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So we are going to look to the scriptures today and see why Jesus did all this stuff. Beloved, the devil has fallen down like a lightning. Jesus foresaw the enemy falling down like a lightning. From day one that you and I declared that we're going to serve the Lord, the enemy has been tormenting us, following us to see to it that we fall flat on our face. But listen, when Jesus died, death couldn't uphold him. When Jesus died, demonic forces that held him couldn't put him in the grave. He did what? He resurrected in power. But today, we want to see the meaning of his sitting on the colt and going to the streets of Jerusalem. Praise the Lord. See, the reason why Jesus did that was he wanted the whole world to know that the Messiah was going to suffer first and redeem mankind. 1 John chapter 3, verse 8 says, "And for this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the enemy." So as he sat on the colt, going through the streets of Jerusalem, he was showing the people that, yes, I am the Messiah. I have come. I am going to suffer not many days from today. And my suffering is going to bring deliverance to people. See, in my country, days like Palm Sunday, people go to church and they have special food that they eat. We have soup that is made through palm kernel, palm nut, you know, and everybody will eat that soup. And we have people also, we have what is called a palm wine, a wine that is made through palm. Others will also drink palm wine and get intoxicated on that day. See, many people celebrate this day with a meaning. But Palm Sunday is not a day for a good soup or a day to be intoxicated or a day to have fun unnecessarily. It is a day that we should admonish what God has come to do for us. You know, it is a day that we should value what Jesus came to do on the cross for us. Hallelujah. He went to Jerusalem on that Palm Sunday, on that fateful day, triumphantly, to declare to the whole people in Jerusalem that, yes, I am the Messiah. I am the Messiah. I have come to redeem. I am the Messiah. I have come so that you people might be healed. I am the Messiah. I am going to suffer. So if Jesus didn't know that he was going to be crucified, then his deity would be limited. But what makes Jesus God is that he knew that he was going to suffer. He knew that the cross was there for him. Not many days from today, we are going to celebrate Easter. We are going to celebrate the death and the crucifixion and the resurrection of our Savior and our Lord Jesus Christ. It is true that Jesus came to die. Hallelujah. And before he came to be crucified on the cross, he went to Jerusalem triumphantly. So this Sunday, I want to see you at church. This Sunday, I want you to go to church, because once upon a time, a day like this, Jesus sat on the colt. And what did he do? He went through the streets of Jerusalem, hallelujah, to show to the people that, yes, I am the Messiah. I'm going to suffer many days hence, but my suffering is going to bring what? Redemption. My suffering is going to bring sanctification. My suffering is going to bring healing. My suffering is going to bring deliverance. My suffering is going to bring joy. My suffering is going to make you people who are bound by the enemy to be what? To be redeemed. Glory to God. That is the meaning of Jesus sitting on the colt and going through the streets of Jerusalem. Praise the Lord. So I want you to understand this Palm Sunday very well. It's not a day to be intoxicated. It's not a day to drink palm nut soup. It's not a day to drink palm wine. It's not a day that you just sit down and go to church with some little palm in your hand. Hallelujah. You should have a meaning of this Palm Sunday. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And what did the people do? They said, "Hosanna, Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord." What is the meaning of Hosanna? Hosanna means save, or save now. Hallelujah. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. You see, the people were looking forward for a savior. The people were looking forward for the Messiah. So as he appeared, they foresaw that, yes, this is the Messiah. Oh, glory to God. Baruch Haba Bashem Adonai. Blessed is he who comes. Baruch Haba Bashem Adonai, who comes in the name of the Lord. Now arise, O Lord, come to your resting place, you and the ark of your might, and we will rejoice as we clothe in your righteousness and celebrate aloud. Now arise, O Lord, come to your resting place, you and the ark of your might, and we will rejoice as we clothed in your righteousness and celebrate aloud. Beloved, see, if I sit down and I look back, the mess that I was in, the trouble that I was in, and where God has brought me today, beloved, it is true that the death of Jesus Christ has a meaning. Glory to God. So if you are not saved today, I want to present Jesus to you. Jesus is the Messiah. You see, people have come and gone. Presidents have come and gone. Queens have come and gone. Intellectuals have come and gone. Businessmen, businesswomen have come and gone. Millionaires have come and gone. But none of them was able to die and arise. It is only Jesus who died and arose. Glory to God. See, I was a drunkard. I've shared this before. Beloved, I'm not a sycophant. Hallelujah. I know whom I have believed. I know what Jesus has done in my life. I know where he took me from and where he has brought me to. So this Easter, let the Lord change your life. Let the Lord mold your life. He went triumphantly into the streets of Jerusalem, demonstrated that, yes, he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. There is no name under heaven or on this earth or in heaven given among men that can bring salvation except the name Jesus, except the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. See, he has overcome the devil. He made a public spectacle over the devil, and he put the devil to shame. Before Jesus died, he celebrated his victory. So we are moving from victory to victory. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. The people saw who Jesus was. They saw how powerful he was. They saw that he was unique. They saw that he was the only person who could save them. That was why they shouted, Hosanna, 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 Hosanna. Save now. Save us now. We need your salvation. We need your salvation. Glory to God. Beloved, who are listening to me right now, I want to urge you that husband, wife, children, business, family, loved ones can never save you. It is only Jesus who can save. Praise the Lord. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna,
Hosanna in the highest. Lord, we lift up your name with our hearts full of praise. We exalt you, O Lord our God. Hosanna in the highest. Glory, glory, glory to the King of Kings. Glory, glory, glory to the King of Kings. Lord, we lift up your name with our hearts full of praise. We exalt you, O Lord our God. Hosanna in the highest. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The meaning of Jesus sitting on the colt, running in the streets of Jerusalem, was to prove to the people that yes, the greatest of all conquerors was in their midst. Jesus is the greatest of all conquerors. Alexander the Great has come. Powerful people have come and gone. But none of them was like Jesus. Jesus is superior to every warrior who has ever lived on the face of this earth. So he, Jesus, moving on the streets of Jerusalem, was telling the people that yes, the greatest of all conquerors is in their midst, has come in their midst. Jesus is a conqueror. He is a conqueror. If you will believe in him today, he will give you that title and you will be more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. If you will believe in Jesus, he will give you power to become a child of God. And every child of God is a conqueror. There are so many things that are conquering you. There are so many things that are putting you down. But if this Palm Sunday, if you will receive the Lord as your personal Savior this day and say, oh Lord, come into my heart, change me, mold me, shape me, make me new. I believe that Jesus, you came to suffer. And through your suffering is when I got my redemption. Through your suffering, there is healing. Through your suffering, there is deliverance. Through your suffering, there is prosperity. See, Jesus became poor that you might be rich. Jesus became sick on the cross that you might be healed. Even as I'm speaking to you, you've been sick for all these years. You've been sick for all this while. Doctors have taken all your money. Physicians cannot have any clue to this problem. But I know of a great physician. His name is Jesus. So he, sitting on the colt and moving through the streets of Jerusalem, was to tell the people that, yes, I have come. I am the Messiah. I am the Messiah. I'm going to die. I'm going to suffer. Not many days from today. But in my suffering, I'm going to redeem you all. Hallelujah. Right now, there are some folks who are still believing that their Messiah is to come. Listen, the Messiah has come already. His name is Jesus. He came as a lamb, given birth by the Virgin Mary. He was crucified. He went to heaven. And what we are looking forward is his second coming. And his second coming, he's no more coming like a lamb. He's coming as a judge to judge mankind. And the Bible makes it clear that on that day, the trumpet is going to be sounded. And a man and his wife would be on bed, and one will go. Two carpenters will be on the rooftop, one will go. Hallelujah. And right now, the Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 10, that the heavens and the stars and all the things that we have in the atmosphere, all are going to be melt with a fervent heat. And if all these things are going to happen, then what type of people should we be? Right now, if you die today, where would you be going? Are you saved? Are you born again? Do you know Jesus? Is he in your heart? This Palm Sunday, hallelujah, I want to see you going to church. I want you to receive the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior. Hallelujah. It's not a time just to sit down and just have fun. This Palm Sunday is a day that we should remember that Jesus went through the streets of Jerusalem, demonstrating to the people his victory. He told them that the greatest of all conquerors was in their midst. Oh, hallelujah. And if you have Jesus as your backbone, my dear sister, you will never be in want. If you have Jesus as your backbone, I tell you, you will never be disgraced. If you have Jesus as your backbone, anything that you touch would be blessed. Wherever you go would be blessed. I shall be praying for you very soon. Hallelujah. May the Lord richly bless you for listening to this telecast. You are a champion. I see yokes being destroyed. I see healing coming to you right now. I see prosperity coming to you right now. Hallelujah. All what you got to do is to repent and say, Lord, I can't save myself. This Palm Sunday, oh God, come into my heart. Wherever you are, I want to pray with you. And next week, I'm going to continue from where I left. This is just the introduction. Next week, I'm bringing a part two of this message, the triumphal entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Palm Sunday is not a day to be intoxicated. Palm Sunday is not a day that we clean our home. It's a day that we celebrate the victory that Jesus had for us. Glory to God. Wherever you are, close your eyes and let me pray with you. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, I want to thank you for the lives of these wonderful people. Lord God, I bless your name because you are so good. I thank you for their lives, Jesus. Father, people have been tormented by the devil. It's about time that, Lord, we receive our deliverance. You went through the streets of Jerusalem to declare how powerful you are, to declare to them that you have triumphed over demons and powers. For the same victory that you had in the days of old, Lord, I ask that you give the same victory to these folks who are listening to this telecast, so that they will testify among men that when they heard this message, your deliverance has come into their lives. Lord, I thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. May the Lord richly bless you. I will see you the same time next week. Hallelujah. The same channel next week for the part two of this message. May the Lord richly bless you. I thank you all for listening in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye-bye. I love you all. Amen.